all of this still seems super daunting to handle, don't worry. That doesn't necessarily exclude you from simulation-based modeling, because there is another simulator tool that we have available to use, which leverages our visual cognition to do this work while still admitting far greater modeling flexibility and capability than spreadsheets offer. That tool, of course, is Machinations. Now, once again, I want to be upfront here and tell you that my experience with this tool at this point is still very limited. I'm just sharing an introduction to this tool rather than giving you a deep guide on how to use it. And I confirm that it is in use by various token designers and engineers, including those that are working at top VCs like Outlier Ventures. If you want to learn more and dive deep, I recommend you look at Machinations' own YouTube channel. It often features Matthew Morris, who I was lucky enough to meet in person in London, and I was definitely impressed by him. Machinations also have their own model library, which you can peruse to help you with your own studies. And of course, once again, there's the token engineering community, which has great resources, lots of enthusiasts working with this tool. And I believe it just partnered directly with Machinations too. I think it's worth us taking a moment to look at the history of Machinations, because it was not developed for blockchain and Web3. It was developed as a tool to help video game designers design and develop their game economies. This underscores things that I've said previously, that while we think of tokenomics as a really, really new endeavor that we're all having to navigate for the very first time, we actually have 30 years of relevant experience to draw upon. Because the problems that video game designers face with respect to their own game economies are in many ways very, very similar and informative for our work. So that's something that I find really comforting. Anyway, the Machinations team realized that it would only take a pretty small pivot for them to add features that would make Machinations ready for modeling in Web3 and blockchain. They have already committed considerable capital and R&D behind that effort and are delivering some exciting results. The last major update greatly expanded our modeling capabilities through an overhauled custom variables feature, which allows for richer process specifications, as well as live data integrations that include the ability to pull live trading data for blockchain assets. I provide a link to the video where these are discussed below. There are also integrations with game engines that look incredibly powerful and exciting. You can use your Machinations model to drive game parameter values in real time, which allows you to instantly balance and calibrate your game from within the Machinations environment. This is amazing, really, and they've got a really funny video where they're using this feature and showing you how it works in practice. I link to it below. You can also collect event data from your game and pull that into Machinations directly. And you're also able to push and pull data from spreadsheets as well. So let's compare Machinations to the other computer tools that we've been examining. First, stating the obvious, Machinations is visual, much more so than spreadsheets because it's fundamentally based in a diagramming language, which, as I explained earlier, offers a lot of potential support for our design thinking. One of the things about Machinations that makes it special, though, is that we aren't just working with any old shapes and symbols here. With all the experience serving the gaming industry, over time, Machinations have come up with a kind of general fundamental function set that captures the main processes and dynamics that are at work in game economies. Your basic common elements include sources, sinks, pools, and converters. These basic building blocks mean that we don't have to code out the variables in full every single time as we would in a spreadsheet or Python environment. In addition, we're given access to variable arguments through a much more friendly visual UI. Last but certainly not least is the animation feature, which really, really, really bolsters the visual support and feedback that you get from this tool. It's so cool to look at as well. What this means is that design and simulation in Machinations can happen at the same time to a very considerable extent. And that's something that we just don't get in Python. It supports a much more free association style of creative flow, where the behavior of the elements that you already have on your page inspires the next. And it's also much more forgiving of trial and error and explorative styles of model development, which you might contrast with the coding-based approaches, which really push you towards having a much more comprehensive sketch of the global system before you start getting any feedback to guide you on what you may want to do next. All this means we can get going much, much quicker with our building in machinations, which is awesome. Paradoxically, I think that's where the risks lie. I said the same thing earlier about spreadsheets. Their greatest benefit is also their greatest drawback. They are easy to use. That makes them very accessible to start building with, but also very able to create horrendous models that are riddled with risks. If any machination users are watching, I know that that diagram I've loaded up on the right looks beautifully elegant, but my point is, how do we know? And how do we standardize that audit assessment? Both professional training and software development training teaches developers best practices for catching and detecting errors with testing, and how to use robust and auditable design patterns. These are not trivial to learn and take practice and discipline to apply correctly and thoroughly. They're slow to develop in comparison to the quick building that these visual builders give us access to. So I would have some concerns that some people come to machinations using it to create systems that they intend to deploy without applying these risk mitigating practices or understanding why they matter. Another related concern is that the UI makes it fairly easy to take some fairly sophisticated choices which the modeler may not have the training to understand. Should your events be driven by a unitary or Gaussian distribution or perhaps something else? In machinations, all you have to do is click on a button and you've implemented a decision. Let's talk a little bit more about auditability. If we look at code, its text-based format can make it reasonably transparent and even self-documenting when done well. You've also got some great documentation tools out there like Jupyter Notebooks and GitHub that really help you get a grip on those important tasks. Spreadsheets are comparatively limited, but good design patterns can support some standardized audit automation as shown here. If we look at machinations on the other hand, even if we have really well-built models, the full specification of the node properties is only revealable by manual inspection through the UI. It's also unclear how you would automate the generation of documentation for these models since logical precedence of nodes may be ambiguous in these structures. Now, I need to point out that the gaming industry has internalized a culture of rigorous testing and strict quality assurance that's applied to games before they go to market. Those processes are adequate at picking up risks that originate in poor model design and help and guide machinations users to develop and maintain good practices as they learn. But what I saw in the blockchain startup space during the last bull run was nothing like that. Everyone was falling over themselves to get tokens listed as quickly as possible without any testing or indeed without any product out there in the first place. In that kind of environment, founders would have taken up anyone who'd been playing around with machinations for a mere 2 weeks in order to raise a few million and push a new token out to market ASAP. The events that have occurred since are pushing everyone to take a more careful approach. But I just want to highlight that there's a real risk that machinations' ease of use ends up luring you and your blockchain stakeholders into a false sense of comfort and expertise. And you really need to watch out for that. But take reassurance that this is a tool that is being developed to support an industry that is generating $180 billion in revenue annually worldwide. Revenues that are recurring and sustainable. So the Machinations team are invested in creating a first-rate tool for that industry and for Web3 beyond. So it comes down to the professional responsibility of Machinations users to learn how to use this amazing tool properly.